Keep back it, fellas. Keep back
it. Natalie, when we get out of here, you up.
Long trip.
I know, but you can. It's fine.
Yeah, you better get a sidewalk out there.
You got a chain.
Yeah. Support and speaking solidarity with his family for this tragic and terrible time. once again, raise your hand. It used to be that a long time ago we hear about stories like Trayvon and we feel helpless. But that's not happening anymore. Times have changed. We figured out that we can come together easily. We can cast our needs. We can make a huge difference and a huge statement. Right now, the world is telling Sanford that what happened on February 26, 2012 is completely unacceptable. Today. So I'd like to take a moment to read some of the statements, some of the messages that those people have left. Tracy Martin and Sabrina Fulton and the entire Martin family. Tabitha from Jacksonville, Florida wrote, I am the mother of an 18-year-old and a 12-year-old African-American boy. And I would want someone to stand up for them. That's why I had a sign. We need to pray for our young men. All the way from Pakistan, another wrote, I live in a country where people are killed just like that. We can feel their pain. I am a mother, and I can't even begin to imagine what Trayvon's parents must be going through. I hope that their efforts to get justice are fulfilled. Ashley from Slidell, Louisiana writes, I'm signing this because this easily could have been one of my friends, my family members, or even me. I'm only 17, and this just makes me wonder about the world I live in. Avis from Cleveland, Ohio. I'm signing this because I'm the grandparent of an almost 17-year-old boy, and it could easily have been him who died that day. Andreas from Norway wrote simply, why am I signing? It would be crazy not to. Finally, Kristen from Las Vegas, Nevada writes, I'm signing this petition because Trayvon represents our sons and daughters. Because our young people are being gunned down in our own front yards. Because an injustice anywhere is an injustice everywhere.
Right.
I am Trayvon Martin, we are Trayvon Martin. Thousands of these messages and these comments. I kept seeing the same words repeated. Injustice, anger, heartbreak, and racism. But what stood out to me even more were these words. Hope, peace, unity, and even forgiveness. These are people who have been moved and inspired by Trayvon's story. These are people who are saying enough is enough. That there needs to be a change in this country, and that what happened to Trayvon Martin can never happen and will never happen again. It's because of every one of you and because of the too many people who signed that petition that the world's eyes are on Sanford, Florida today. So please keep it up and thank you very much for being here, sir.